Hi everyone and welcome for this new tutorial how to paint quickly this Viking who come from a brand new game. We are going to be on a game on tabletop. This is like a Kickstarter platform. These miniatures come from Epic Games Factory, so I have the luck to receive it before the release. We come on 2 April on game on tabletop. So let's go for the paint. So at beginning I make all the minis directly. This is resin casts, so it's pretty easy to assemble. I don't know, but it's easy to make it and to glue it. And after I start by I prime at beginning with a brown from Army Painter. This is a spray, and now I come with the color Flesh 2 from Pro Color to push my first highlight on every part. I'm going to make the same on the 3 different miniatures to have all my my hero and my partner of the hero already painted. So in Heroclash you just have one hero and you can stuff the hero with some special sword or shield, or you can use this partner to help the hero into the battlefield. So now I'm going to come back by adding a little bit white into my flesh too, to push my second highlights on every part. As you can see, I am using an evolution airbrush, and I make my mix directly into the bottle. It's really more easy than taking a brush and mix. That's really more easy. So let's go for the second highlight. Don't push too much white on this moment, because white is going to make everything very very flat, very dull. So don't hesitate to take care about white color when you push with your airbrush. So after this airbrush step, I do the same on the 3 model. That's going to make me some gain of time. And after that, I'm going to start by using some wash. I use some wash from Army Painter to push my shadow on every different part with different kind of color. For example, after that I'm going to use some flesh wash on the flesh and some strong tone and dark tone on some different part like leather, shields, and every non-metallic metal parts. Just before this wash step, I come back only with white, and this time I'm going to use this white only on non-metallic metal parts to be sure that's going to have a different way of treatment, to have a different kind of paint at the end, to make a big difference between my non-metallic metal, for example, and my flesh. Don't hesitate to take a look. I make some a video tutorial on my YouTube channel how to use an airbrush. So if you have some question, don't hesitate to take a look to see how I use my airbrush. I will be present at Adepticon in Chicago and in Gen Con at end of year, so don't hesitate to come to me. I will be a lot of time on the booth of Happy Games Factory, and by the way, I will give some teaching, some masterclass at Adepticon. Now I start with my flesh wash on every flesh part. And I'm going to reach every part in flesh with this color. I use a brush. The range is Raphael number 8404 and size 2. Sometimes I use a size 1, but the most important is to have a good, I don't know the exact word, but in English, but it's a reservoir, a tank you have at the base of your brushes. So it's allow me to don't come back a lot of time to my palettes to keep more and more paint, because there are some water in this tank, and that going to come time after time to push this water into my color. Don't hesitate to like this video, to push some comments, to give me your feedback. That's always a very good motivation for me to continue to give you every Sunday one more tutorial in English. I will start, I already start to make some special video for my Patreon, so if you want to see this special video, don't hesitate to subscribe to my Patreon, and this video will show you, for example, how to push your the level from a tabletop miniatures to a better level miniatures. So now I come back with my strong tone and I push into all my leather parts. I enjoy to show some very simple step to make some pretty cool miniatures without taking very too much time. So let's continue with my dark tone this time on every non-metallic metal parts, and I continue on the different on the next one. Don't hesitate to push more wash into the recesses to be sure that this wash is going first time and in a more strong way into these recesses. That's the best way to be sure that your wash is going in the good direction. As you can see, I preserve all my flesh parts. And I push all this strong tone into all the leather parts and the hair. The miniature is sculpted by Stéphane Simon. With a very very talented sculptor. He sculpted a lot for monoliths, for Mythic Games too. So don't hesitate to take a look to their Facebook page. I come back once again with my dark tone to create more and more contrast into my non-metallic metal parts. Thank you. After that, I'm going to start all the classical paints with to push my highlights at beginning on the flesh part. For that, I'm going to use a survivor skin from Army Painter. This is very similar to barbarian flesh, so if you have any barbarian flesh, you can use it. And I'm going to push these highlights only on the parts who take the more light when I see these miniatures just under the light. So as you can see, I push only some points on some parts who take not a lot of light, and I'm going to push a lot on the part who take the more light. At this moment, the dilution of my color, it's the same. It's something like milk, so you can push in every direction and the color will stay, and you can always see just under your paint the previous color. So it's going to help me to make my transition in the most easy way. I'm going now to add some ivory color from Prince August into my color, into my flesh color. This is just some few points, but that will help a lot to push my highlights on the points who are a big focus for my ace. And with this same ivory, I'm going to push every what is the word for that? So every ridge with some white to create a very good non-metallic metal. And when you push every corner like that, you can easily see the beginning of a good non-metallic metal. I make the same on the sword and on the different armor, on the minis, on the shield too. In this new kind of tutorial, I show you more elements. So you can more easily see the step depending on the surface I use. So that's a little bit more long, but I hope you enjoy it, because it take me more time, but I think it's give you more information depending on the surfaces you are going to paint. For example, on the shoulder right here, I push my non-metallic in a different way than on my shield or on the sword. So that can be very interesting. I hope you enjoy it. Don't hesitate, these miniatures will be available at Game on Tabletop, so from 2 April to 11 April. For a very quick crowdfunding to launch a brand new game whose name is Heroclash. So don't hesitate to take a look to that. As you can see, I use the side of my brush a lot to push my color. Because the sculpts help me a lot to push the highlights on every corner. Thank you. So now I'm going to start the leather with the color is red leather from Prince August. So it's going to help me to create better lisibility to the piece. So I push this color on every leather part. And I focus always on the part who takes the more light. I'm going to add a little bit white into my basic color to push more and more highlights on my leather. So you can see I'm going to focus on very some few parts. It's very important to create a good transition to step by step reach a very lower and lower surfaces. That help you to create a good transition, and you gain some time by the way, and you have something who help a lot about the focus. So I'm going to come back with some this is a very old washes. I'm going to push this wash in into the leather to push a little bit more shadow into this part. This the name of this ink, it's something like the chestnut ink who came from Games Workshop a long time ago. I don't know what is a reference, what is a similar reference from now, but the name is chestnut ink. So this is a it's a very good ink to push some shadow into the leather. I'm going I hope I will meet a lot of you when I will come at Adepticon and in Gen Con this year. So don't hesitate to come to me with your miniatures, to show me your miniatures, and that will be a really pleasure to give you some advice. So I come back with some black color to push once again my contrast into my non-metallic metal. On the hair. On the beard too, on the shield. As you can see, more I'm going to paint, and more my this is going to be more some tap with my brush, and I'm going to reach a very small part. This is a very important to paint in the good way. More you are going to paint, less you are going to put color. So for the last some of the last step, I'm going to come with some red laser again to create a layer to push a little bit more color into the leather. and now I come back with some dark sea blue to push once again my shadow into the leather, using some very dark blue color into very red leather is going to give you a more deep effect. So now I'm going to make the same kind of step on the berserker. So I'm going to use in the same way so barbarian flesh for the first highlight, and after that I'm going to use and to push more and more highlight by adding some white into this color. As you can see, the step is the same, but I'm going to push my color in some different way because the miniatures is not the same exactly. So there are a lot more flesh on this one, so I'm going to take a little bit more time to develop the flesh on these minis. It's pretty, it can seem simple, but... So let's go, I'm going to add a little bit more ivory into my barbarian flesh to push my light. Every time on a very smaller surfaces. Just to remember, I use a Raphael 8404. Size 2 or 1, depending on the size of my model, but for example right here I use a... Oh, I don't remember, but I think it's a size 2. So you always have a very... you can make a lot of different kind of details with that, and the quality of the brush is pretty cool. I will add some link into the description to put you some link to some store who have this kind of brush. I'll start with the leather, so I'm going to push my red leather on every leather part, on the head too. I'm going to, I will probably paint this model in the most quality way, and this will be able probably on the Happy Games Factory channel. So if you want to see a little bit more tutorial, you can subscribe to the Happy Games Factory channel so you can see more tutorial. I come back now with some ivory to push my highlight on every non-metallic part. I push the highlight on every edges to have always more contrast into my non-metallic metal. That's a very, very important point. And I come back on my leather just by adding a little bit ivory into my red leather I use. This color comes from Prince August, so you can find it probably the same kind of color from Valero. If you search a book of painting, you can find the art of the miniatures actually on backer kits in the light plate. So if you are interested, don't hesitate and just take a look. More I paint and more I'm going to try to make some distinction between the different kind of surface, for example here the beard, just by adding some dark tone washes. That's the perfect way to push the focus on the flesh, for example, because I'm going to make a very dark and push more shadow on these parts to make the highlights on the other part most impressive. I come back with my red leather to push a little bit more color because it seems to be too much flat. And now with some dark sea blue, I'm going to push once again my shadow into the recesses. You can push this dark sea blue into the flesh too, that's possible. Just take care because it's a very covering color, so the dilution is very important. Don't hesitate to try on your palette before using it directly. So I come back once again on the leather to push a little bit more highlights on every part of the leather. And I come back once again with my ivory to push once again my contrasts on the different piece. And let's start for the last warriors. So this last Viking have a shield and an axe. So there are a lot of non-metallic metal on that one. So I'll start by that, directly by the non-metallic. So I'm going to use my ivory and push every edges with that and every surfaces. So this is exactly the same way I already do, but this time I'm going to have more surfaces, so it's going to be just a little bit more long. This video, I accelerate the video after my painting, so take care by take your time to paint and to use the technique I show, because it's take always more time to try something new. Don't hesitate to tell me in the comments what do you want to see for the next video. I will take care about that and find a way to make what do you want for the next one. I probably propose an arc for the next week, and I will try to put my hand on the new Games Workshop stuff very very soon, because I like it, and I will show you every month, for example, two Games Workshop tutorial probably, and two other range miniatures tutorial. So don't hesitate to tell me what will be your favorite choice. I'm going to come back on the flesh, but there are not a lot of parts of flesh, so I come back directly with some black on all my non-metallic parts. On this last one, I'm not going to show you every different step, but I decided to focus on the non-metallic parts, because this is the most one of the most important parts of the miniatures, because there are not a lot of flesh, and I already show you two times the leather, so don't hesitate to put in the comments a link or something if you find a way to paint these miniatures. So that will be a pleasure for me to give you some advice directly in the comments. So let's go, and thanks for watching this video tutorial. I hope you really enjoyed. Don't hesitate to put a comment, to subscribe to my YouTube channel, to support me on Patreon, and I hope you like these miniatures. We will be able to go on battlefield at beginning of 2 April to the 11 on game on tabletop. Thank you very much and see you soon.